In today's episode, we're going to be looking at phoenix grafts. That's a composition or integration of living and dead wood together to create bonsai. We're going to also look at some wonderful Lingnan Punjing pines, and we'll visit a master who makes wonderful porcelain bonsai pots. Wonderful Lingnan pine punjing with living and dead wood integrated together by nature. And there's also a way that you can do a man-made living and dead wood bonsai creation. A phoenix graft is a compositional method of bonsai creation, and it involves the integration of living and dead wood together. Every region has their favourite sort of wood. In Australia, we use red gum. Best to prepare your piece of driftwood by cleaning it thoroughly, then painting it with a mixture of lime sulphur, one part lime sulphur and three parts water. This turns it a ghostly white. The lime sulphur has a pungent odour, so I like to clean the excess off before I begin to work the tree into it. Of course, every piece of driftwood has its own characteristics, as does every piece of plant material, so you just have to be crafty and ingenious in working out ways to make them fit together. Then, once they're fitted, let them grow long. This establishes vigour and strength in the greenwood. I've trained this whippy juniper to a piece of driftwood with pieces of wire, but now I'm going to put some screws in to hold it more firmly in place. Simply drill a hole through the middle of the living wood and drive home stainless steel screws. I've done it in two places on this particular specimen, and soon the bark will grow over the top of the screw and it'll be concealed inside the wood. Remember that the best way to get the living wood to bond to the dead wood is to allow the shoots to grow long. Let the shoots grow long before you begin trimming. So there's my take on a phoenix graft. If you want more information, of course, there's much more detailed and in-depth content on the World of Bonsai Series 2 DVD. And you can get your copy of the World of Bonsai DVDs at bonsaifarm.tv. And if you go to bonsaifarm.tv's online shop, you can find a special offer where you can get the entire Bonsai Farm library of DVDs. That's 16 hours of original content and insights and methods for a specially reduced price. And if you're a member of our community that gets out and about and likes to get to shows and nurseries and all other places where bonsai people commune, you might like to be a distributor for the bonsaifarm.tv library of DVDs. Just drop me a line at the email below and I'll tell you all about it if you're interested. And now, here's a really interesting Lingnan pine punjing.
我認為這些松樹的結構是一個代表，它很多松跌頂跌枝，它頂部盤子體現到這棵樹是年齡很老才能夠形成這個結構。
本來這棵樹如果說樹灰彩彩就好簡單的，可以說是很多人不喜歡的，但我反而看對了它這個曲度，這個曲度下來，我曾經考慮過偉哥這件事，我曾經想考慮不過這枝東西，就是這麼小棵，但這枝必須減弱它。
係係係。
啊，咁佢有咁嘅韻味喎，一衝嘅咁上下啊，咁啊，但係咁嘅情況佢又有嘅韻味，咁呢個長出嚟，但係而家咁割呢，就好似好唔捨得咁我自己。
啊，
過一段時間呢支粗咗咧，我估計住下要行咗呢套。
仲更加簡潔啲添，又好好。
去咗佢，可能係。
係。好啊！如果咁樣個嗰個品味會仲好啊！
呢只減弱佢，
係
呢只減弱佢。
Jingdezhen is China's ancient porcelain capital, with a rich history and an array of glorious old kilns. Venerable ginkgo posts and beams give shelter to these wonderful old structures. If only their walls could talk, imagine the stories that they might tell.And in the modern day, there's an array of wonderfully gifted ceramic artists here in Jingdezhen. I came here to catch up with Hu Kangzhong. I'd heard about the wonderful porcelain pots he had made for Japanese collectors. Mr. Zhong has retired from the pot-making business now, but he dragged out a few pots from the archives to show us.
This is a 五彩山水. This is different, it's different. It's being burned.它的养烧就是一个难度，就是呢，容易还不是加毒，容易变形。但是考虑这个是香器，香器就是手工制板子，这是那个瓷板，然后四块镶嵌起来，在顶上这面上一块的也是采取这种呢，裁剪的，然后这里面这个框是采取一种雕刻的形式。形成一个仓，这我们叫开堂啊，形成一个仓。这个彩绘的是叫也是仿古代的五彩山水，五彩山水。这几个是同时当时一起做的，都是仿康熙年的，都是仿康熙年的。这里的还有一个这个特征呢，就是。底部张针，底部啊，全部张针，怕它底板下一个下沉呐、啊，采取底部张针的办法，顶住它。
什么样的针呢？
那就是一种那个耐火材料。
耐火材料。
那个像针一样的，这么短短的，顶着这里一根根的针顶着这里，然后下面一个泥板放在那个窑具上。它烧的时候下沉，它下沉不了，顶住它的，就是才支撑呢、啊，起一个支撑作用。是一个叫那个什么茶叶帽，高温釉。那这个呢，这个也就采取这种烧成方法的。这反了。像这种大件的东西，非得这种烧成，否则呢，它都会往下面下沉的。这是仿大清乾隆年的，这采取每个钉这么长的钉，全部支撑好。它要下沉下，只是顶住了，它起个支撑作用。这个釉是叫我们叫高温的茶叶沫釉，像茶叶沫的一样的颜色，这种釉。这个大花盆，它首先要解决就是变形问题。它这个像这个，应该说是解决变形是比较完美的，几乎是达到了没有变形的这种程度。但是偶然有一点，它宁愿外凸一点，往外凸一点，不希望呢往里面凹一点点，往里面凹一点就变形就不行了，就交不了货了。往外面凸一点可以。